Invest, if you talk about investment protection, how much is amount you have to spend it for the services, deploying and taking the servers and all those things. The code or the service or the investment or the service will be work as side by side. The services, whenever, whatever the methods you are going to write, you have to pay like that. If you are going for the upgrade, you have to pay a lot. But here in the bottom side, you see, if I wanted to make a web service enhancement, security, enterprise services, or ASMX service, you have to give only one shot payment, one time investment. But here, but if you wanted to go for ASMX with security, you have to pay separate. If you are creating a service, you have to pay separately. Means adding extra functionality, adding extra feature to the service, you have to pay extra amount. But when we talk about the WCF, everything will be covered in one amount, one investment that the WCF is giving us. Integration via interoperability, it's nothing but it's on nothing but a net. I created a service that can be integrated with anything because that can be consumed on intranet applications. And that can be consumed on a, or that can be accessed by the web, means outside their boundary. And interoperability, it's nothing but when we talk about a client can be anything. A platform can be anything. That's an integration way. Enabling interoperability, see, I told you, whenever the client sends a data to the server, you have to take care about the data, what type of data you must have to, you are going to send to the server. You have data formats. When we talk about .NET remoting and the Windows services, because .NET remoting and the Windows services are working on the intranet, in the physical, the systems which are physically connected, the data format should be binary type of data, binary format. But when we talk about the WCF services, you have different types of formats. There is a, in the metadata, when you added a service, you will get two things. The protocol, the binding which you have used it, and the data format, what type of data you are going to share it. You have to set it and you will get it by adding the references. Service enhancement is giving you, see, security. In the metadata, what you will get? You will get a security, reliable messaging, transactions, messaging, these things. Our XML is the normal one. XML means web services is always returning in form of XML only. So just leave this one. Service orientation. Server 1980s, we are working on object-oriented polymorphism, encapsulation, inheritance, and all those things. 90s, we were working on component-oriented. Component-oriented means media player. The component which are directly communicating with your hardware and the operating system. And in 2000 onward, we started working with the service-oriented applications. Means when we talk about web services, I create one service that could be used by some other one. Four tenets of a service orientation. It's nothing but the features of the web service. Boundaries are explicit, services are autonomous, share is contract. I'm not talking about a class. Whenever the client and server want to communicate, they have to go with the contracts. A contract is nothing but a interfaces. Compatibility based on policy. You can configure the services with some policies so that other person can use it. I'll tell you frankly, like in the AWS, when you set up your account, create one service over there in the web AWS. Okay. So you have to set some policies. So whoever the person who is going to take a service or going to consume that services, he has to be access that policy, then he will be able to do that, otherwise it won't. For security purpose, WCF runtime architecture, if you talk, we have already gone through ABC, address binding contract. Address means where your service is being hosted. Binding means what type of binding you have provided, and the contract means what type of data you are going to expose or you are going to accept it. Clear. Transport is nothing but address means where you deployed it. It should expose one endpoint. It should expose some transport layer, whether the service will be accessible through TCP or HTTP. So you have to define the transport. And use the transport. So whenever you are using accessing a particular URL and you are going to send or share some data to the server or server to the client, the data should be in some format, encoder or decoder. On top of that, you can apply your securities, means the binding. What type of binding you are going to use it. If you wanted to make your service as a secure, if you want a simple web service, go with the basic HTTP binding. If you wanted to make your service as a secure, then go with the WS HTTP binding. If you wanted to more secure on the messages, because data is transferred in form of messages only, then go with the other service, other binding. How it goes from the transport to encoder, then it will go to the security, then our code is being ready now. Service code, incoming, outgoing. See, envelope is coming here. This is the transport, the wired. See, whenever the client sends a data in form of envelope, you all guys already knows, in earlier days we are writing some postcards. Envelope letters, right? Not the love letter. Envelope letters only. So what we had over there, to, from, and the body and all those things. So in the middle part of that, the body which you are going to use it, you can say as the data will be transferred, which are written in the body and to, from, whatever the headers where you are going to send it, what are the securities. You have to put it into the header section. Once you got the envelope ready, then you need to transfer to the TCP protocol, means use the web service or the URL. What is the security channel over there? Means whatever the binding you have is specified. Is it secured? Yes. See, this is the part of messaging layer. If you use the one binding related to a messaging, you will get two things. Transport protocol, TCP protocol, or security channel. Service model layer, you have three things. Instancing behavior, transaction behavior, or CLI type integration. Okay, what is that? Instancing behavior is nothing but how many objects will be created on server side. What is the instance mode for that particular service? Is that a single mode? Single mode means I create one service. Remember guys, application state we discussed in ASP.NET. Means application state variable is accessible to anyone. They can add the data, that would be remain same. An object will be one only. Session is for a specific user. Means whenever the person is going to log in, it will create one session that would be specific to one user only. But when we talk about application state, it is a single object, single variable at the server side, and everybody is using it. So same way, what type of instance behavior you are going to send, you are going to expose it for that particular class object. You have to say, single, we do have retrend, single, okay. Transaction behavior, you have to specify. Scalar type integration is nothing but whatever the data you are going to use it, you have to set it. The scalar type, it's nothing but a data contract. We'll see that. Service code, same flow, responded to the client. Means it is coming from the client, it moves to the server and again return to the data in form of envelope only or the formatted data. Service model layer, messages layer. See, this is the last model. These are the channels which we were talking about. Bindings, it's channel, protocols only. We do have a HTTP protocol, TCP protocol, reliable messaging, SMTP, custom channel, queue transport, or named pipe. These are the things which is available in the service model layer or messaging layer. When we talk about messaging layer, means the data which you are going to transfer it. These are the three things which is coming here. I'm not going to write anything for that. It will be managed by WCF itself. But this is the concept. In the service model means a server side. Messaging layer means consider as the data is getting transferred from client to server. So you have to set these things. Just set some properties. And this is the service model. I was talking about instancing behavior. See what type of behaviors we have. Concurrency behavior, throttling behavior, error handling, metadata behavior, whatever. Concurrency, nothing but how many objects is being created, how many number of users are going to use that service. After reaching the number of users hit to that service, I wanted to block the other users like that. We can set a concurrency and the throttling behavior in that. Metadata, nothing but a metadata behavior. Means whatever the visual you are going to expose it, you can. If you don't expose a particular method, you can exclude it. Error handling means we talk about the fault contract.
Hello, sir. Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Sir, thoda sa client ka call aa raha hai. You can continue, sir. Main baad mein
likhunga. No issue, no issue. That's it. The WCF part, the concept. Yes, Suresh. Akshay, tell me any doubt, any confusion regarding the concept?
So one question, like,
yes,
we have a tool for ticketing in our HSBC.
Yes.
So whenever we open it in a it is CA service desk.
Okay, CA. Okay, got it. And we do also have in the previous.
Yeah. If you see, the browser URL is ending with .exe. So what is the concept behind that?
I'll tell you, people are using that URL rerouting part. Okay, means see, I can give any URL, but in the background you have some different endpoint. Right, okay. Now you are accessing a web service, for example, facebook.com. If I am the developer, I can make that URL. Once you hit the facebook.com, you will hit ashwin.com. It will be navigated to the facebook.com. We can modify because I don't want to expose my endpoint to the person. I can rewrite the URL by using HTTP handler or HTTP module events. We can do it. So it was part of that. That is why the MVC and the RESTful services came into the picture. So you can define your routes so that the end user will not be able to understand what class or what action is being defined. Action we can identify, controller we can identify over there, but exactly not. I can define a different route. I can give a different name. So actual method will not be understandable by the other person. So hacking will be reduced at that time. So they have...
Okay.
Any other questions? Suresh? Otherwise, I am going to start 1, 2, 3 questions to all of you. Suresh is not responding.
Hello?
Yes, Suresh.
Yeah, blackmailing now.
No questions. How it happened? You don't have any question?
No, actually, I have seen that services. I want to know the main difference while implementing between the SOAP and REST, because what you said .wsdl is related to the SOAP.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And whatever the URIs we are passing, it's related to the REST protocol. So both will work on HTTP only. But here in REST, we are having GET, POST, PUT and DELETE. But whatever the SOAP, how exactly it will work? It won't have any GET, POST, PUT and DELETE, right?
Correct. True. We do have some other methods we called as a web invoke.
Okay.
In the web services. Okay. Indirectly, we do have all those things, okay? But actually, see, when you talk about RESTful services, all those, so like web APIs, nothing but web service only. But they have designed the architecture in a different manner. So whatever you are having a method, get, put, post, delete, it is also web services, but in a different way. So in the RESTful services, in the web API, or in the MVC, they have designed in a different way. That's it. That's an architectural design only in the web service, in the RESTful or the MVC, nothing else. And when we talk about, if you are comparing the web, are you comparing with the web service or the WCF or the RESTful services? Three are totally different. In the WCF, what happens if your client is only a desktop-based application? If your client is a, you can say, web-based application, that would be really like suitable for the WCF. But when we talk about a service can be, means a service can be accessed on the mobile, because mobiles will require only a JSON data. So in that case, you can go with the RESTful services, nothing else. If you targeting multiple devices, then you should go with the RESTful services, not the WCF. But if you have predefined the targeted machines who is going to consume it, then go with the WCF. The second most important thing, if you are comparing the SOAP, so SOAP always return the data in form of XML. But when you are talking about the other parts, means RESTful, the web API, you can return any type of data, whether it is a plain text or the JSON or anything. So in the WCF, you can have a lot of bindings which is not available in the web services. Web APIs or MVC. It is not replacing web service, WCF. I'll tell you frankly, if somebody is asking you, is RESTful services is replacement of WCF? No, never. It cannot be. Because WCF services is specifically built for targeting multiple clients. If it is a desktop-based application, you wanted to use that service as a TCP protocol, then you can go with the WCF. But now, web APIs or RESTful services will never expose number of endpoints. Got it? And now comparing with the SOAP, simple object access protocol, whatever you have in the SOAP, it was a plain text only. For the security purpose, you have to do a lot of things using a via SOAP. But in the WCF or in the web APIs, you don't bother about those things. Everything will be handled by that framework only. So it's not the web API, RESTful, MVC, it's not replacement of WCF. It's, you can say, what are the targeted clients? What clients you are going to target? Or the, what so that service is going to target? Is that a Windows? Is that a like intranet based or internet based? Then you can go with the web WCF. But if that, if you're targeting multiple devices, I'm not talking about intranet, I'm talking about only the web, then you must have to go with the web API or the RESTful services. And there is one more concept here. For example, Akshay is already using some web service, ASMX web service. Okay, I wanted to create a WCF service. Whatever the methods he is using it in the web service side, Akshay is using right now in the ASMX web service in his project. Now I wanted to create a same service which is going to be target to the intranet, which is available to the TCP protocol. I cannot do with that. I have to go with the Windows service. So I'll create a web service, I mean a WCF service. I'll expose two endpoints. One is same as the person is using, Akshay is using. I'll expose one endpoint, which is related to a TCP protocol. The service is totally changed now, but the methods, the logics, everything is same. Even the URL is also same. And Akshay, don't bother about those things. whether the service is running as a WCF or the web service. He don't bother about those things. Because he needs only the URL, right? And he don't want it to change the URL. So WCF is telling, okay, you require, you added a reference as ASMX, so I'll expose the endpoint with the ASMX only. So that means the WCF is still communicating with the older services as well, older clients. If I created a WCF services and 1,000 clients are using my old ASMX web services. So if I ask him, can you change your web services now? They will tell, oh, what you did here, I don't need it. I need only the ASMX service. So what the WCF is saying, create one endpoint which is targeting to your old clients. That's it. But the RESTful services will never provide you. It is just a design, architectural design as a RESTful services we say, where you have a get, put, post, delete methods. You can also do with the services and the web, but in a different way, different manner. The other part is the RESTful services. If you are comparing it, what we call multi-targets, that's true. Platform is also good fun. These are the things actually. I forgot one liner, what we call. I'll tell you once we'll see that. Okay. So these are the things which we have it in the WCF. But you cannot, in the web API, you cannot expose multiple endpoints. You have to go with the one endpoint. It cannot be worked with the TCP protocol and all those things. Got it? And you have to return the data in form of JSON or XML. Nothing else. And data would not be safe. I'll tell you in the RESTful services. If you wanted to secure the data, then you have to do a lot of things. You have to go with the SSL and all those things, which we were doing in the web services as well. Nothing else. But you have to decorate it in the web API. Any other question? Suresh, Akshay, any doubt?
No, actually.
Okay, great, great, great. Any doubt, let me know. Okay. Okay, so we'll do one thing. Okay, Bala will join in the next other sessions. He will not join with these sessions because he already lost a few classes. He told me before Akshay, even though he's not joining due to some reasons. So he will continue with the other batch. Okay, we'll continue with this batch. And we'll start the programming side for the WCF tomorrow. And we'll integrate the same things in the ASP.NET. Okay. And we'll see that master pages and all those things in coming week. And then we'll start with the MVC. And meanwhile, Akshay, you can do some practicing. Yeah. Okay. If you have any doubt, let me know. So we'll see that. Okay. So we'll start with the entity. We already have one. Edio.net, but I'm not going to repeat the Edio.net. We'll go entity framework. Okay.
Yeah, I was there. Yeah.
Yes. So please, guys, be there on the session. Okay. Don't miss. And I'll take a session on the weekend.
Yeah.
So please be available on the weekend as well. Okay. Thank you. We'll start it from the tomorrow because it's a coding. I cannot complete in 10 minutes. So better to start from tomorrow. Okay.
Okay.
The recording and the PPT.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll see. And just go through it. Okay. Okay. Thank you, guys. Have a good night. Bye.
Bye.
Good night. Bye bye.